Black Bear Pass. Looks a little wet. Looks a little cool. Whew, looks a little rocky. Have my balance woke up yet. Trying to run this trail early. Be a little less deep traffic. These trails get a little rough when you can't quite go the speed the Jeeps go. They go a little bit slower. Which is how Jeeps are supposed to do it. The slower you go, the cooler it is. But on bike, you gotta have so much momentum. So I'm just trying to keep rolling here. Something to keep in mind, these trails are harder than any video you watch will show. You think watching the video is like, ah, I can do that. Then you'll get out here and it's going to be like, nope. Look at that Jeep, man, that is cool. I'll have to bring mine out here. That is cool. I don't know if I can get around this guy. Flip side, probably not. Wait. Gonna have to wait. Dang it. Scenery's cool. Rocks are slick. Pass. At least they label it good. Little stream. Yep, that's what you don't want to do. taking me over. Holy smokes. Throws you off to the side because it's off angle. Wants me to ride over here. Definitely getting my intro course to riding on the rocks. This is fun. At least the gate's open. like, what line? Theme of the whole trail so far. What line to run? Alright, I'm gonna go up here and do a camera check. Vegetation line now. This ain't bad. My first snow patch. It's kind of cool. Haven't been up this high yet. On the trip, it's been raining. That's another thing for anybody wanting to come out here. It's the first week of August. They've been getting rain every day. Been keeping us off the trails. I don't like that one, so I'm gonna go this one. If it's not it, I'll go back around. Yeah, like I was saying, rain, rain, rain. Yeah, my bike, it's a stock bike, stock jetting, it's jetted for Ohio. Whatever jetting it came from the factory is what I have. So, it's, I know I lose a lot of power. I noticed, like, even at, like, 8,000 feet, it runs. Runs fine. I mean, it'll run. You can ride it. Still accelerate pretty good, but I can't do a power wheelie. Not even at 8,000 feet. Not with stock jetting. It's just that the altitude zaps the power out of it. I noticed up here, I'm starting to lose a little more higher up I go. like straight down. I'm gonna let him get down there a little bit. If I can get around him. Yeah, see, it's easier for me. I have to keep rolling where they can just chill and enjoy the scenery. Me, I'm trying not to drive off a cliff. Now I'm riding a brake. That's cool. Thank you. Get the old feet wet. Slick, slick, slick. Oh man, this is awesome though. My tool bag. Just hit me in the old backside. That felt pretty good. These rocks are something else. Skid plate. It's like, where'd the trail go? Yep. Well, at least they left me some mud on a downhill. So the tires I'm running are D606s. Run those a lot. I've run quite a few different kinds of tires, but these work pretty good. I think they're an all-around decent tire. I do a lot of road riding, back and forth to work, buzzing through town, and then couple off-road parks. They hold their own in the loose stuff. air them down. I'm running 18 PSI in the front and 20 in the back. Which, is that the right pressure? Heck, I don't know. That's just what they're at. But now when I run the loose stuff, not so much sand, but like pea gravel on that, I usually run about 14 front and back. We got a dunker. Let's take a look at this. Man, I don't even see them Jeeps. Couple Jeeps up ahead, that's cool to see. Crossing them over. So far, pretty pleased with running my jetting the way it's at, just leaving it alone. This is my second XR650L. First one, I did the whole jetting and pipe and K&N filter and smog block off. Yeah, that's cool, you know, whatever. But this one I'm leaving stock, except for tires. I added a skid plate, different foot pegs, which that's really helps out. And then a rack in the back, put my crap on. But leaving this one stock. And as you can see, at least the jetting's holding up. Whereas if I had it jetted rich down at Ohio level, I wouldn't be able to ride up here. It probably wouldn't even run, it'd be too rich. Feels weird on my tire. Let's check it out. Something don't feel right. Start to see the town down below. Tell you right. Got my dad along on this trip. He's not running this trail. He just got his bike not too long ago, and he's only had it off-road once, so he's still trying to get his off-road bearings dialed in on it, so he said he was going to pass on this one. We did some trial runs yesterday, and he's running a KLR, and it's kind of back tires really slipping with how wet the trails are. But we've been hitting a lot of roads whenever we can, but the stupid weather's been holding us back. We've been here like 3-4 days and haven't been able to really ride trails. At least not the popular ones. Man, we tried doing, well, we did all the way. We ran that last dollar road and it started raining on us. Dang it. Side, and we're gonna go down here. So anyways, last dollar road, pretty much a road, ran that, wasn't too bad, got into the woods section, and that stinking road turned to like mud. Wow, that's like, so that was bad. And then the road, it was like a greasy mud after it started raining on us. We were like sliding down the mountain. It was crazy. That was more scarier than doing this stuff. And those guys are going that way. I'm gonna hug the rock face. This is any better than that. Yeah, I'm gonna cruise around them. Gotta make sure I leave that clutch out. Oh, this is. Like you, front tire just drops down. I'm gonna stop, do a camera check. I gotta find a spot where I can leave the bike running, because I wanna make sure I can start it. But I like them. So, here we go. What do we got here? kind of hoping it doesn't rain when I'm on this guy. Oh, that was dumb. Man, this is down. Using a combo of engine brake, back brake, and feathering the front a little bit. I think the, if someone wants to do this, the thing that'll help you the most is low speed maneuvers if you want to practice doing something. Low speed balance. Come on, bike, stay running. Bump. Arms are getting a little tired. Cable laying across the road. So down there at that town, that's where I'm going. Telluride. And I want to run the trail and I don't want to run any shortcuts, if you know what I mean. Cable makes your tire roll. Jeez. I'm hugging the right side. I've seen some people do this one, and they hug the right side. So you got that in your face. About went end over end there. Myself in a little pickle here. You know, I just want to say, typically the sound of frickin' waterfalls is relaxing. I'm not relaxing right now.
Captain Bronco. Alright, steps are done. Holy smokes. Good waterfall. I don't really want to give you another shot here. I want to stop. So. All right. Let's get this done. This rock waits to fall until I get down. At least get by. I should have looked at my watch when I started the trail, see how long it takes for someone who's putting along. Part's not bad. I don't mind this. Oh man. Now see, now come on. Like I said, they showed videos of it that didn't look like this. This is, now I don't know why they did 500 point turns on the Jeeps. Sorry, my camera works a little shaky. I would ride that lane closer to the cliff, or not the cliff, the mountain, but a lot of these my mirrors would be hitting. Switch back. All right. Jeez. Alright. There we go. Man, this is really cool. That's the beauty of a bike right there. Beauty of a bike, being on a bike. Sorry, folks, another picture. I think what I'm going to do is tomorrow I might take the roads back around and maybe come check this out instead of running Black Bear again. Thank you. backpack's kind of fun. I'm just enjoying the ride. Trying to soak in some scenery. Just the old tire wants to roll over. Rocks are more of a pain than you think. A lot of hikers. It'd be kind of fun to do. Morning. Yeah, still got a lot of downhill to do. Morning. That'd probably be fun to do. Do a relaxing stroll. Morning. Man, that guy, that older guy's getting it. Share the room. Puppies. stopping right there. Yeah, tip on the switchback, you kind of get out far enough where you can take a look and then pick a line and go. I don't know where to go.